Once upon a time, there lived a beautiful queen who had one wish, to have a beautiful daughter. One winter day, while the queen was sewing by the window, she accidentally pricked her finger with a needle. She quickly wiped the blood with a piece of tissue and made a wish.
Wish for a baby girl with a skin as white as snow, eyes brighter than the most dazzling gems, lips as red as cherries, and a heart full of joy.
One day, the queen's wish came true as she gave birth to a beautiful baby girl, whom the name Snow White. Years passed quickly, but their happiness was short-lived. The keen-hearted queen fell ill and soon passed away. Not long after, as the king grew older and weaker, he remarried a new queen, who was very beautiful but also cruel. She was arrogant and jealous. Every day, the queen would look into her magic mirror and ask it a question.
Magic mirror, who is the fairest woman in the land?
The magic mirror would reply,
"None other than you, my queen, are the fairest of all."
The queen would be very pleased with this answer. Since the arrival of the wee queen, everything in the palace changed because of her evil actions, and the kingdom faced many problems. To handle these issues, the king had to leave the palace. The wee queen was overjoyed, for with the king away, she could do whatever she pleased. Years passed quickly, and Snow White grew into a beautiful young woman. Not far away, a prince saw Snow White's reflection in the river as he drank from it. He looked around but didn't see anyone.
One day, the queen stood before her magic mirror once again.
"Magic mirror, who is the fairest woman in the land?"
The mirror replied,
"Well, forgive me, my queen, but it is not you. Snow White is the fairest."
The queen was furious when she heard this answer from the mirror, so immediately summoned her favorite hunter and gave him a terrifying order.
"Take Snow White to the forest and bring me her heart."
The soldier brought Snow White before the queen.
"Welcome, Snow White. I thought you meet me both inside the palace. Go. Feed fresh air to the forest. Don't worry, my terrifying hunter will always think of her."
The hunter led Snow White into the forest. Although he was ordered to follow the queen's command, he couldn't bring himself to harm Snow White, who had pure and kind heart. The hunter warned her never to return to the place. As the sun set, he left her alone in the forest and returned to the palace. Snow White was very frightened. Alone in the dark forest, she sat under the tree and began to cry. Eventually, she fell asleep. In the morning, she was awakened by a bird song and surrounded by many small animal friends. Since the animal loved and trusted Snow White, they showed her the way and led her to the dwarf's cottage, which was as tiny as they were. With hesitation, Snow White opened the door. Everything inside was very small and messy. Snow White didn't know who lived there, but with no place to go, she decided to clean up.
Na 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 na.
After cleaning the house and making herself comfortable, Snow White used the small kitchen tools to cook and eat. The bed in the cottage was also very small, but she was exhausted. Thinking there was no danger to her, she lay down on a group of beds pushed together and fell asleep. That night, the seven dwarfs who owned the cozy cottage returned home after working in the mines. When they entered, they were surprised to find the house clean and the smell of delicious food. Dopey in his clumsiness smelled soap on the floor, and Dove tried to think of what had happened.
"There's more things suspicious about all of this. Wokal have done this."
"If I could sleep, I'd be sure they'll know the answer,"
Sleepy said as he yelled The seven wives quickly went upstairs. When they entered the bedroom, they couldn't believe their eyes. On their tiny beds lay a beautiful girl. Hearing the noise, Snow White jumped up in fright, seeing 14 eyes from the seven wives starting at her. Hastily she spoke.
My name is Snow White. I'm sorry if I start you. I mean no harm.
Yes, we believe you. Underways, you all have cleaned the house and cooked for us.
Toof replied, the introduced themselves.
We are the seven dwarves. This is Happy, Grumpy, Dumpy, Sneezy, Wistful, Eidoof, and the Sleepy.
The six dwarves and Snow White love. Snow White was delighted to have seven more friends. She told them all that had happened, and the seven dwarves were saddened to hear it. They asked Snow White to stay with them, and she agreed, always helping out. They began to live happily and peacefully, but their happiness did not last long. One day, the queen asked the same question to her mirror, Magic.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest in all the land?
The mirror's answer remained the same.
Well, forgive me, but it's not you, Your Majesty. Snow White is the fairest of them all.
But the queen thought Snow White was already dead. Realizing that the heart of the hunter had brought was actually a tears, she decided to handle it herself. On a cheerful morning at the Seven Dwarfs' cottage, Snow White waved them off at the door. Toof repeated his usual words.
Don't forget our right. If a stranger knocks on the door while you're away, don't answer.
Alright, Toof, but don't be late coming home.
While Snow White was preparing dinner, there was a knock at the door. She didn't expect the dwarves to be back so soon.
Who is it, Toof? Is that you?
From outside came the voice of an old woman.
I mean no harm here. Please open the door.
Through the peephole, Snow White saw a poor old woman whom she thought couldn't possibly harm her. So she opened the door.
Oh, lovely girl, I miss a passing old woman. If you call spurs a bowl of song, I will be very grateful.
Snow White broke the old woman in and gave her a bowl of hot soup.
Thank you, dear. I have no money, but I do have a green apple, the most delicious. When bad will taste like heaven.
Curious, Snow White took a bite of the apple and immediately fell unconscious to the floor. The old woman was none other than the wicked queen in disguise, and the apple was poisoned. Even one bite was enough to put Snow White into eternal sleep.
When the seven dwarfs returned, the four Snow White lying unconscious on the floor, Toof discovered an apple with a big mark.
The apple she ate must be poisoned. This must be the work of the wicked queen.
Snow White looked beautiful even in her deep sleep. The dwarves placed her in a glass coffin adorned with precious gems on a hill where all her forest friends could see her. One day, the prince came to the forest where Snow White lay asleep. Her friends led him to the glass coffin where she slept. The prince couldn't believe what he saw.
Isn't this the beautiful princess whose reflection I saw in the river?
The beautiful princess he had seen in the river and dream of was now lying asleep right before him. He lifted the lid of the coffin and kissed Snow White. At the moment, Snow White and the princess dream came true and their love broke the curse as Snow White opened her eyes.
At the same time, after learning what happened to his daughter, the king shattered the magic mirror and banished the wicked queen as far away from the palace as possible. Snow White finally returned to her palace and was reunited with her father. Snow White and the prince held a grand wedding celebration.